Hi, I'm Dominic, and welcome to Be Inspired with Dominic. Today I'll be making another wand, but I will not make it out of wood. I'll be making it out of fluorescent acrylic from upcycled display stands. And this is it. Thing is, you probably can't see how awesome it actually looks.
First, I need to cut these display stands up into sheets. For that, I lower the table saw blade, set the fans to a bit more than the width, and run it through as often as safety permits. Fluorescent acrylic has the property to steer light from the flat sides to the edges, making for an interesting effect. For the smaller one, I use the miter gauge, and for the center cross, brute force does the trick. The big issue with this project is to turn that flat acrylic into a cylinder. Sparing no pains, I've undertaken excruciating scientific research into which method yields better results, and these results are astonishing. The answer is, it depends. There is method 1, where you simply cut the acrylic into squares, and don't ask about the dots. The thing here though is that you have to remove more material later, since you need to take off a lot of corners, and that material will be wasted. Method 2 is more work, but a little less wasteful. I've printed a honeycomb pattern and I transfer the points to the acrylic. Now I drill holes at the dot positions with a drill larger than the width of my bandsaw blade. Then, you guessed it, on the bandsaw, I cut from hole to hole to separate the hexagons. Here we have a comparison. Both piles came from equal pieces. That's a reason to feel good about yourself, right there. I also had a few cutoffs of yellow fluorescent acrylic on hand, so I cut a few pieces out of those as well. Now I need to combine all those hexagons into a single blank. And there we go. Well, not quite yet. I did some tests and found that CA glue works best for this, better than plastic glue for model making, which probably works well on other kinds of plastic. CA glue also sets pretty fast, which is why I eventually stopped using clamps. Just make sure to keep the slices stacked properly and quickly, because you do not want the result to be skewed. Once I was done, I glued two blocks of wood to the end, so I could put this between centers on the lathe. And up to this point, I actually thought I would turn this. But round things can be a bit boring, and I'm saying that to justify what I did next, even though I did it because I thought it would go faster. First though, I did actually try to turn it, and even sand it. Then I took the angle grinder with the flap disc and went to work. At first, I only wanted to get rid of the edges to commence turning, but I just kept at it until I had a smooth surface. Then I started thinning down the front until I was satisfied with the result. The good thing about the wooden blocks is that you can sand them away in order to reach the edges of the acrylic. The non-rotational shape feels a lot more interesting in your hand than a traditional turning, which means that I should not have assumed that traditional sanding would work. You know, the kind you use on the lathe with the piece spinning. This only sands the high points, so I had to switch to hand sanding, and a lot of that. After sandpaper, I used these micro mesh sanding pads, and as far as I can tell, they do a good job. On that, I use CA glue as finish, a technique common in pen turning. You apply the glue on the slowly turning workpiece with a paper towel to spread it out. You have to be quick about it when applying it, and then giving it enough time to cure before trying to add another layer. Longer than that, at the very least. So, more sanding and reapplying of glue. But in the end, I'm satisfied. The top block of wood snapped off easily enough. The bottom snapped too, but I glue the pieces back together and remove the wood more gently. If you can call a miter saw gentle, or a belt sander. where I also shape the tip and give it more sanding and sealing later.
Not perfect, but quite frankly, I think it's perfect enough. The fluorescent property of the material, it does make it look kind of odd to look at in a positive way, but on the one hand, the camera is hard pressed to actually pick up this effect. I think you can see it here, down there a little. I'll put some more beauty shots of it up. But the interesting thing, and I thought about this to add as a feature, a drill in here and add an LED light, but I got one here. And you can't see the difference whether I'm holding the light against it. There's very little awesomeness going on like that, so there's maybe a slight difference depending on how you look at it, but I think the tendency of the material to take the light and bend it, or to refract it more properly to the edges, it'll prevent light from down here to actually reach the top, so I'll just leave it like it is. It calls for a nice stand at some point. I hope you enjoyed this, and I hope you can take something away from this video, whether it's how to actually make this wand, or how to cut up acrylic material to make round blanks with a little less waste. Either way, thank you for watching. If you enjoyed this video, please share it with your friends. If you didn't, share it anyway. Doesn't hurt, does it? If you have questions, leave them in the comments below. And as always, remember to be inspired.